Hello students, in previous lecture we have discussed about the law of symmetry. So we have discussed about the plane of symmetry, axis of symmetry, as well as center of symmetry, as well as we have discussed the symmetry elements for the simple cube. Now today we are going to discuss about the types of crystals and Bravais lattices. Now very first we'll discuss about the crystal lattice. What is exactly mean by it, that we'll discuss. So the crystal lattice is the three-dimensional regular arrangement of constituent particles, that is either atom or ion or molecule, with the crystal is known as a crystal lattice. So when we are going to discuss, I'll show you one model of the crystal, which is a simple cube. So three-dimensional regular arrangement of constituent particles. So here you can see the model of simple cube. It's a three-dimensional regular arrangement of the either atom or ion, or you can consider as a molecule. So you can consider this as a one atom or ion or molecule. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth one. So this is a simple cube. You can see this. There is no change in the arrangement of the constituent molecules or ions or atoms. So this is known as a crystal lattice. The position of these particles in crystalline solid relative to one another is usually represented by the point, which are known as a lattice point or lattice site. So it is shown by the point when you are going to draw the diagram. I have shown you model, but when you are going to present it by using a diagram. So in previous lecture we have discussed the diagrams also. At that time it is presented by the point known as a lattice point or lattice sites. Now we'll discuss about the space lattice. The three-dimensional regular arrangement of lattice point in space is called space lattice. Again, I'll repeat, listen carefully. The three-dimensional regular arrangement of lattice point in space is called space lattice. Now, we'll discuss about the unit cell. What is exactly mean by the unit cell? The smallest building block of crystal consisting of atoms, ions, or molecules whose geometric arrangement when repeated in three dimensions will generate a complete crystal, that is known as a unit cell. So suppose if you are going to consider the simple cube, again I'll show you model, this is a simple cube. Suppose if I'm going to show you a previous model, this is a simple cube, both are simple cube. There is a regular arrangement of the constituent particles. Yes, there is a regular arrangement of constituent particles, as well as this is a smallest building block of the crystal. Okay, if you are going to cut it into more, then what will happen? The unit cell will break up. So this is a smallest building block of the crystal, that is known as a unit cell. Now we are going to discuss about the types of unit cell. There are two types of unit cell: primitive unit cell, or also known as a simple unit cell, and second is non-primitive unit cell, or also known as a multiple unit cell. So very first we'll discuss about the primitive or simple unit cell. Okay, primitive or simple unit cell. Primitive or simple unit cell are those in which particles are present only at the corner of the unit cell. So again I'll show you model. So this is a simple or primitive unit cell. You can see the particles are present only at the corner. corner. If I change the view, the particles are only present at the corner. So this is a simple unit cell. Next, non-primitive or multiple unit cell. Non-primitive or multiple unit cell are those in which particles are present at the corners as well as at the some other sites. So where particles are present? Particles are present at the corner as well as at some other sites also. So now we are going to discuss in details about the non-primitive or multiple unit cell. So non-primitive or multiple unit cell are of different type. That is body-centered, face-centered and end-centered. So very first we'll discuss about the body-centered cubic cell. Denoted by capital BCC, body-centered cubic cell. So there is one particle at every corner of the unit cell as well as one particle is present at the center of the cube. So again I'll show you model. Here you can see the particles are present at the four corners. Not a four, you can consider eight corners. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So particles are present at the eight corners of the simple cube as well as the particle is present at the center of the body. Yes, you can see that particle is present at the center of the body, known as a body-centered cubic cell, B, denoted by BCC. Next type is face-centered cubic cell. Face-centered cubic cell in which particles are present at the center of the each corner. In addition to that, the particles are present at the center of each face. So again I'll show you model. That is a face-centered cubic structure denoted by FCC. So this is a model for the face-centered cubic structure. You can see there are particles are present at the eight corners of the unit cell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. As well as the particles are present at the center of each face. Here, here, here and here, as well as at the both, that means at all faces. Known as a face-centered cubic structure. One more is there which is included in primitive, non-primitive unit cell. That is a end-centered cubic cell. Now for the end-centered, I don't have a model. You can imagine it that the particles are present at the corners of the simple cell as well as the particles are present at the center of two opposite faces. Now in face center, the particles are present at the each faces. Here in end centered, either particle will be present over here and at the opposite face, that is at the exactly here. And on the other faces, the particles will not be present. So exact model is not with me, but you can imagine that is a end-centered cubic structure. End-face-centered cubic structure denoted by EFC. Now next we are going to discuss about the crystal system. Okay. Now what is exactly crystal system? A number of 230 crystal forms are possible. So in total there are 230 crystal forms are there. All of which have been observed. They are grouped into 32 classes on the basis of symmetry. So there are 32 classes known as a 32 point groups, okay, known as 32 classes or 32 point groups. These point groups are clubbed together to form 7 crystal systems. In total, they will form a 7 crystal system, which are named as cubic, rhombic, tetragonal, monoclinic, triclinic, hexagonal, and rhombohedral. So, there are total 230 crystal forms which are grouped into 32 point groups. And these point groups are clubbed together to form 7 crystal systems. Now, we'll discuss about the Brevis lattices. So, what is exactly mean by the Brevis lattices? That we'll discuss. Brevis is a French mathematician. He stated that there are 14 fundamental and unique ways in which particles can be arranged in three-dimensional point lattices. These are known as Brevis lattices. Why they are known as Brevis lattices? Because after his death, they are named in memory of him. That is known as a Brevis lattices. So, in Brevis lattices, A, B, C are the intercepts along the X, Y and Z axis respectively. And alpha, beta and gamma are the interfacial angles. So, A, B, C are the intercepts made by that lattices, and angle between the faces is denoted by alpha, beta, gamma. Now, the characteristics of this 7 crystal system along with the 14 Brevis lattices, they are summarized in one table. So, now we'll discuss that Brevis lattices, which are grouped into the different form. Okay. So, I have made a table in which name of the crystal system, parameters of unit cell, that is intercept and interfacial angle, type of space lattice, minimum symmetry elements which are given in brief, and examples are given. So, very first we'll discuss for the simple cubic system. So, for the simple cubic system, the intercepts made are A equals to B equals to C. You can see again model. Here, there is a simple cube. And in this simple cube, the length, breadth and height is same. Hence, A equals to B equals to C. As well as you can see the interfacial angle, alpha equals to beta equals to gamma is 90. You can see alpha, beta and gamma all are equal to 90. Suppose if you are going to see like this, then suppose this is X axis, Y axis, Z axis, then in each axis the angle made is exactly equal to 90. Now, the type of space lattice are the simple primitive cubes which I have shown just now, as well as body centered. This one is body centered. In this also simple cubic pattern is there. A is equals to B is equals to C, as well as alpha is equals to beta is equals to gamma, as well as face centered cubic system. A is equals to B is equals to C, as well as alpha, beta, gamma all are same. So, they all are included in this. The minimum symmetry elements are fold. There is three-fold axis is there. Examples are NaCl crystal, KCl crystal, CaF2, NaCl2, O2, ZnS, copper oxide, lead, silver, mercury, alum, diamond. These are the examples. Now we'll discuss about the next, that is orthorhombic or rhombic. Now in this orthorhombic or rhombic, now I don't have models, but you can imagine the intercept A is not equals to B is not equals to C. So just now I have shown you the model in which A is not equal to B is not equal to C. alpha is equals to beta is equals to gamma, all are 90. Okay. The type of space lattice are orthorhombic, body centered orthorhombic, face centered orthorhombic, end centered orthorhombic. So all orthorhombic are there. The minimum symmetry elements are 3 mutually perpendicular to fold axis. The examples are KNO3 potassium nitrate, K2SO4 potassium sulfate, BaSO4 barium sulfate, MgSO4 magnesium sulfate, PbCO3 lead carbonate, MgSiO4 that is magnesium silicate, as well as rhodium orthorhombic, RH orthorhombic sulfur crystal is there. Okay, so these are the examples for the orthorhombic. Now next is tetragonal. In the tetragonal, the A is equals to B but not equals to C. Alpha is equals to beta is equals to gamma is equals to 90. The example is simple primitive tetragonal and body centered tetragonal. The symmetry elements is 1, which is a 4-fold axis. The examples are nickel sulfate, stannous oxide, titanium oxide, zirconium silicate, tin, then lead tungstate and potassium hydrogen phosphate. So these are the examples. Now next is monoclinic. Now in monoclinic, the intercept parameter is A is not equals to B is not equals to C, alpha and gamma equals to 90 but beta is not equals to 90. The examples are simple monoclinic and end-centered monoclinic. The symmetry element is 1 to fold axis. The example of nickel sulfate 10H2O, sodium borate 10H2O, calcium sulfate twice H2O and FeSO4 that is iron sulfate. Okay. Next one is triclinic. In triclinic, A is not equals to B is not equals to C and alpha is not equal to beta is not equal to gamma is not equal to 90. The example is simple triclinic, that is space lattice is simple triclinic. Symmetry is 1 to 1-fold axis. The example is copper sulfate 5H2O, potassium dichromate and hydrogen borate. Next one is hexagonal. In hexagonal, the A is equals to B but not equals to C. Alpha is equals to beta is equals to 90 but gamma is equals to 120. It is a simple hexagonal. The minimum symmetry element is 1 6-fold axis. The examples are AgI, silver iodide, zinc, zinc oxide, cadmium sulfide, mercury sulfide, lead iodide, magnesium, cadmium, graphite, quartz and ice. So this will include your hexagonal crystal system. And last one is rhombohedral or trigonal. Now in this, A is equals to B is equals to C, alpha is equals to beta is equals to 90 but gamma is not equals to 90. The example is simple hexagonal. Symmetry element is 1 3-fold axis. Examples are sodium nitrate, iodine chloride, antimony, then Bi, calcite and magnesite. So these are the examples. So this is all about the 7 different Bravais lattices. In next lecture, we'll discuss about the characteristics of cubic system.